Hey guys, with just one line of code, you can turn your Streamlit application into a SaaS. That means only authenticated users with a valid subscription can use your application. You can achieve this with a new package called st-paywall. After setting it up, you only need to add one more line of code to add Google Authentication to your app and to receive payments. Let me show you a simple example. When I click this button, I'm prompted to log in with my Google account. Once logged in, this button changes to Subscribe Now. Clicking on it redirects me to Stripe, where I can subscribe to the service. After subscribing, I can access the content of my app. In this video, I will guide you through the step-by-step process to set everything up. So without further ado, let us dive in. Alright, let us kick things off by installing the package. Open your terminal or command prompt, type pip install st-paywall and hit enter. With that in place, let us sort out the file and folder structure for this project. To start, we need our main script. I'm naming mine streamlit_app.py. Then I will set up a folder and call it .streamlit. Inside this folder, we will create a secrets.toml file. So this setup is essential for using the paywall package. Now let us fill out the secrets.toml file. Therefore, head over to the official st-paywall documentation. I've dropped the link in the description box for you. From there, you will want to copy these lines into your secrets file. So I will copy those and then paste them right here. As you can see, this file stores our credentials and API keys. It has the details for the Google authentication and spaces for the different payment providers. Currently, the package supports two payment providers, Stripe and Buy Me a Coffee. On a side note, Stripe provides a test environment to double check everything runs smoothly. So therefore, you can also see that there are test keys. We will dive deeper into that later in the video. For now, let us set up the Google authentication. The steps are clearly laid out in the documentation. If we jump back there, I will head to the authentication with Google section. First off, you need to create a new project in the Google Cloud console. Let's open that link. Then click on select a project and create a new one. Name your project and hit create. It might take a few seconds. Once that's done, you will set up the consent screen. This is what users will see when they log into your Streamlit app. Choose external and then create. This is how the consent screen will appear to your users. Fill in the details like the app name and the support email address. I will skip the app domain details and add the developer's contact email. Once you've added the info, move to the next step. Here I'm sticking with the default settings and won't add any test users. Finally, you can head back to the dashboard. Alright, with the consent screen set up, let's now create the credentials for this project. Click on Create Credentials and then choose OAuth Client ID. For the application type, pick Web Application. Feel free to name it whatever you like. In this section, you will have to input two URLs. One is for testing, and the other one is the actual domain you will use once the app is deployed. If you are unsure about your final URL, no worries, you can change it later. However, since I have decided to deploy my app on the Streamlit Community Cloud, I will add my URL now. It's going to be https://mycoolsaas.streamlit.app. Remember, choose a different URL, because this one will already be taken by me. When running your Streamlit app locally, it will be on localhost at port 8501 and it will use HTTP and not HTTPS. For the authorized redirects URL, use the same ones but add a forward slash at the end. This step is important. Missing it could lead to issues later on. With all that said, click on create. Now you will get a pop-up message displaying your client ID and secret. These are essential for our secrets file. I will copy the client ID and paste it here. Then I will do the same for the client secret, replacing the placeholder value. And just like that, users can authenticate themselves on our web app. Now let us dive into creating the Streamlit app itself. I will quickly draft the code and then walk you through it. Alright, I've started by importing the necessary libraries, setting some basic configurations, and adding a title. The next step is our authentication line. Only authenticated users with a valid subscription will be able to see their subscription status and email. That means if somebody is not logged in and has no subscription to your service, they won't see this part of your app. So if you have already a Streamlit app, which you want to turn into a software as a service, you just need to add this line. Okay, now let's test it out. When I go back to my terminal and run the app, this is what it looks like. In the sidebar menu, we will now see a locking button, which was automatically added by the st-paywall package. If I click on it, I will be asked to log in using my Google account. Once done, I will be redirected to my app, which is currently served on my local host. Okay, this part already worked. However, we get an error message because we haven't set up the required payment method. So, when I go back to the documentation, we will see that there are two payment providers available. For this tutorial, we will choose Stripe. If you haven't done so already, you will first need to set up a Stripe account. Just follow the steps on their homepage to create an account. Once that is done, you will need to create a payment link. Let me open this URL in a new tab. Now, when you follow the link, you will be redirected to the test mode. As I briefly mentioned at the beginning, with Stripe you can test things out in a safe environment. In this tutorial, I will go through all the steps in test mode. However, when you are ready to launch your SaaS and you want to receive payments, you can create a live payment link by clicking here. Okay, with that said, let's create a product. I will name mine MyCoolService. Next, I will import a price and set up the payment option to recurring. This is important as it won't work with a one-time payment. Optionally, you could also add a description and upload a product image. Once done, click on Add Product and then Create Link. You can now copy this link and paste it into the secrets.toml file. Since I created a test link, I will paste it here. If you use live mode, paste it into this section and set the testing mode to false. Alright, with that done, we are almost finished. Next, we just need a Stripe API key. To get one, go back to the documentation and follow the provided link. Remember, you are still in test mode. To create a live API key, you will need to toggle off this button. With that in mind, I will make a restricted key. For permissions, it's important to grant customers read access. Optionally, you can give this API key a name. Once done, scroll to the bottom of the page and click on Create Key. Next, reveal this key and copy it to a clipboard. Back in my secrets file, I will now replace the Stripe API test key. Okay, with that we are almost done. I just realized I hadn't set up the redirection URL for our app. Let me quickly handle that. This is the address we used when configuring the Google Cloud project. For me, the redirection URL will be mycoolsaas.streamlit.app. With that sorted, let me return to our app and refresh it. Next, I will log in with my Google account. After that, we will be redirected to my local host. Now that we are logged in, the button has changed to subscribe now. Clicking that button takes us to Stripe's checkout page. Since we are in test mode, you can use the following test credit card information. Once you click on subscribe, you will see a success message. So everything is working as expected. However, in a production setting, you would likely want to redirect the customer to your actual web app instead of just displaying this success message. You can set that up by modifying the payment link. In this section, you can input a redirection URL. For me, it's again mycoolsaas.streamlit.app. And that's it. We are now ready to deploy our app. I will be deploying it on the Streamlit Community Cloud, but you can choose any other hosting service if you prefer. I've previously made a tutorial on deploying a Streamlit app to render. You can find the link to that video in the info card above and in the description below. For deploying it to the Streamlit Community Cloud, you will need a requirements.txt file where you list all your dependencies. In my case, it's Streamlit and st-paywall. You should also create a gitignore file to ensure you don't upload your secrets to your online repository. The file name should be .gitignore and it should contain the path to your secrets.toml file located in the .streamlit folder. The final step before deploying is uploading these files to your GitHub repository. I will use VS Code for this. By pressing Ctrl, Shift and P on my keyboard, I can open the command options and from there, publish my project folder to a public repository on GitHub. Once done, I can view it. Alright, my project files are now visible on GitHub. With that said, I can deploy the repo to the Streamlit Community Cloud. Simply search for Streamlit Community Cloud on Google and log in with your account. After logging in, create a new app. You will want to choose the repo we just created and specify the app URL. In my case, the URL will be mycoolsaas.streamlit.app. And now you can deploy it. This might take some time, but once done, you will most likely encounter an error message. This is expected because if you recall, we didn't upload the secrets file to GitHub. Instead, you will need to enter that information into the settings of your app. To do so, navigate to your apps, and then go to Settings and Secrets. Here, paste the content from your secrets.toml file. Ideally, when deploying your app, set the testing mode to false to utilize the actual Stripe payment link and API. However, for this demo, I will leave the testing mode on. In that scenario, I will also have to modify the redirection URL to ensure that even in test mode, the users will be redirected to my app after the Google authentication. Okay, now I can save these changes and reboot the app. It might take a bit, but once it is up, your app will be live. As we saw earlier, there's our logging button. And after the successful Google authentication, this button changes to subscribe now. Clicking on it redirects to Stripe's checkout page. After users subscribe, they are turned back to your web app. Unfortunately, currently this package doesn't support cookies, so you will notice that I'm logged out again. But when I log in, I can access the Streamlit app. So remember, every refresh results in a logout, so the user needs re-authentication. As this package is relatively fresh, it may utilize cookies in the future versions to keep the users logged in. This would, of course, offer a better user experience. But for now, it is what it is. Alright guys, and that is how you transform a Streamlit app into a software as a service business. And if you need to modify your app after the deployment, the process is straightforward. You just need to make the necessary changes, and then commit and push them to your GitHub repository. I typically use the VS Code integration for this. After that, you will see that your Streamlit app updates automatically. One last word before you go. Currently, this package supports payments through Stripe and Buy Me a Coffee. Setting up the Buy Me a Coffee subscription is even simpler. You can find all the detailed steps in the documentation. I also guess that more payment options in the future will be added. So I recommend staying updated by regularly checking the st-paywall GitHub repository. Lastly, I wish you all the best with your SaaS application. And as always, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.